In today's Mommy Matters, you may keep tabs on your teenager's social media accounts on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, but are you sure you know about all of those accounts? Lindsay Eaton explains why you should watch out for Finstagram.
We just can't stay off.
Scroll, refresh, and then scroll some more.
We just always want to be on it, checking to see what other people are doing.
From beach vacations to breakups to the best brunch ever, if it's happening, it's going on Instagram.
See a bunch of selfies. Lots of selfies, actually.
The Instagram you see here is just one version. There could be another version called a Finsta, a fake Instagram account. Finstas allow users to create a totally separate account and a somewhat separate identity.
My instant reaction was, what is mine putting on hers?
The name associated with a Finsta may not be clearly connected with a real Instagram account.
A Finsta automatically just creates a mindset of, I can do a little bit more, take a little bit more risk, and I'm a little bit more tempted to do something I wouldn't normally do.
On Finsta, the followers are a smaller circle and the number of likes don't matter as much.
Girls on Instagram, they have to have their makeup done right and they have to have the right filter. And then if you go on Finsta, girls will have no makeup on.
With the perception that parents aren't seeing the post, just close friends are, some teen users go for more provocative posts.
Yeah, some girls will post videos of them doing stuff they shouldn't be.
One of the lies of the internet is no one will ever know.
Chris McKenna runs an internet safety company called Protect Young Eyes, hosting seminars across the country, teaching teens and their parents about online dangers.
I talk to a lot of families who think their kids are saints, okay? I don't care what kind of saint you think is sitting down with you at the dinner table. The internet will find your weaknesses.
For most adults, Instagram is a place to share a picture. For teens, it could be much more.
Instagram represents an identity. Instagram represents how I want to manage how the world perceives me.
Figuring out if your teen has a Finsta isn't hard. Chances are, if they're going back and forth between a real account and a fake account, they're staying logged in to both of them. So,
if you click on that little up arrow next to the username at the top, you would see if there were multiple accounts.
The known account is the one you may even follow. If you find a second account, that could be their Finsta.
Kids will figure out a way to use it inappropriately long before parents ever figure out how to use it appropriately in the first place.
Also, if your teenager is managing an Insta and a Finsta, most likely both accounts are following one another to keep tabs. Look through their followers to check up.
Get in their device whenever you want. Suck it up and be a parent. I look at parents all the time and I say, listen, there is no such thing as sissy parenting in the digital age.
Okay, we all take deep breaths together now and say, we can do this. Yes, we can, parents. Okay, there are practical uses for a Finstagram account. If an adult wants to keep a more professional account separate from their account that's just for fun. Now, if your teenager, and it should be a teenager, not a child should not have an Instagram account in the first place. If they has a Finstagram account, ask them this question. Why do you feel like some friends should see one side of you and other friends should see a different side? Hopefully that'll open up a good conversation that you can have with your teenager.